A lot of excitement around Overwatch 2, but also a lot of confusion. In the opening ceremony, Jeff Kaplan explained that they want to sort of set a new standard for what a sequel means, and said that you'll still be able to carry over your progress and play across Overwatch 1 to Overwatch 2, but that still leaves a bunch of questions unanswered, right? So what we were able to do is get on some panels with the developers and ask more specifically where the cutoff points are for the different consumers and what content's where, and this will be available for you to watch in full. We'll be uploading that panel separately, but I wanted to condense the information down into a video where I specifically talk about what to expect, because a lot of people are still confused on, is it a different product? Do I have to buy Overwatch 2? What do I get where? The gameplay we'll be using in the background again is going to be from Emongg, so please do me a favor and go check your boy out. Emongg is the nicest guy in the world. Please leave him a follow. This video, we're more so going to talk about PvP, the division between the two games, and other updates and doodads that we've heard about coming actually in a week to the PTR. A lot of exciting things all over the place, so let me just start. It gets confusing because Overwatch 2 is doing something no game has ever done. It's upgrading the graphics and a bunch of other things to the Overwatch game, and the details still sound a bit fuzzy, but the most important detail is that if you are not interested in PvE whatsoever, Overwatch 1 PvP will still be available to you. It's all gonna run like normal, so there's kind of a merge system in that regard, so much so that I would be a lot more relieved if they just called it an expansion, but I think for marketing reasons or to sort of set a new standard and as well explain how different this game is, they're calling it a sequel, right? But it's a sequel in the way that they're also bringing along the old stuff, rather than having the disposable Call of Duty style replacement of the whole game and tossing everything out and sometimes reselling you the same stuff. They're not doing that. Whether you only own Overwatch 1 or Overwatch 2, you'll be able to play competitive PvP and quick play all the same like you normally did. What isn't clear is exactly what you'll be missing out if you don't upgrade to Overwatch 2. The things that are obvious is that you won't get the story missions, the hero missions, and any of the other extra content, but we all should expect that. I've kind of heard two different answers as far as the other upgrades though, where one developer said one thing and another developer said another thing. And with any of this, you can assume it can be subject to change, right? So for example, the graphical update is one of the biggest changes to Overwatch 2. It doesn't seem like the team is all in agreement yet whether that will modify the base Overwatch game everyone has already, or if you need to buy it in order to get that graphical upgrade. Conversely, they're doing other little things to the game, like upgrading the HUD, where for characters like Mercy or Zenyatta, who have a supporting ability onto a teammate, now there'll be pictures to show up to be more clear about what your abilities are doing. You also probably notice that there's a new HUD, there's new hit markers, and there's new animations to the fringes of the screen. I think it makes sense for everyone to be running on the same system, so they may update the original game, but they also said that if you don't upgrade, you may just be running on the old aesthetics overall with the way Tracer used to look. And in fact, if you prefer the way old Tracer used to look, they said you could play on the old settings even if you did buy the sequel. Okay, so I think that clears up the major concern. Any new mode, any new maps, any new heroes come out simultaneously to both games. They affect both games differently because Overwatch 2 is mostly PvE, but if you never played Overwatch 1, you want to jump in, well, you can play everything in Overwatch 2, or you can only play PvP and the old modes in Overwatch 1. You can do whichever one you want. And I think once that's said, it's pretty obvious where the rules stand, right? Now, there's other cool things that they've talked about adding to Overwatch 2. For example, multiple new heroes should be coming. The cast should be expanded. And Jeff specifically said that they want to make it feel impactful. I mean, they've talked about multiple heroes in the works for quite a long time, and that's what they're gearing up for. For example, we know for sure that Sojourn is coming in Overwatch 2, both in the PvE and the PvP once Overwatch 2 launches. What isn't so clear is the development cycle for regular PvP hero launches. Obviously, we didn't get a new hero for the main PvP game right now, but one will be coming before the sequel comes out. So we're going to be on a new cadence of update content to normal PvP. I know it feels like the competitive PvP as we know now is getting swept under the rug, but in the panel, you'll notice, I don't know if you can hear the audio of me asking only PvP related questions. I was concerned about the player base that's existing, and Jeff Kaplan pretty much looked me right in the eye and said, the competitive PvP is the core of Overwatch. And even if they mess everything up about Overwatch 2, that's where the focus is. So he really put his foot down and said, that's our goal. It might not feel that way because everything's talking about the PvE stuff, but there is some really good news coming down the line of what they're looking at for PvP currently. So for example, as early as onto the PTR next week, Jeff Kaplan said, they're going to be introducing, finally, the ability to play other modes while queuing. This is a huge buff, especially to streamers and high-ranked players, or anybody who's queuing for a mode that takes quite a while to get going. Like, competitive arcade mode sometimes can be a while, obviously a lot of damage queues can be long for a lot of people. During that, they're going to be releasing a new deathmatch game mode. They gave us no details on that, but there's a new style of deathmatch. I secretly hope it's somewhat similar to Hero Gauntlet or something like that, but you'll be able to just check a box, just like skirmish essentially, where you automatically get placed into a match that's a waiting room for your actual queue and let you play that. But Jeff said you also could play workshop game modes, the arcade, the training room, basically whatever you want. That's really good news. And although I wasn't able to sneak in the specific question asking about role queue incentives or an IOU system that allows you to fill for roles but then get a benefit later on, so for example, if you're trying to queue for DPS but you're willing to fill, there isn't really an option for you right now. I wasn't able to nail down that question, but Jeff Kaplan himself did say that they're looking at addressing the high level queue times and ways to go about fixing that. Not a massive update, but at least they're listening to that being a problem and they're aware. Other things that you might hope they'd be aware about, I was sure to ask about the problem of power creep. There's a word that we've talked about a lot, you and I. Content creator friends of mine all love talking about power creep, or hate talking about it perhaps. And Jeff Kaplan didn't give a great answer in reply when I asked if the dev team is focused on combating power creep. He essentially said that he thinks the community overblows that term and uses it too much. Obviously, I would somewhat disagree, but at the very least, he did state that they are looking at a trajectory to balance the game over time. So more of the same slow, methodical balance we can expect. He alluded to the fact that they nerfed all the ultimates across the board in order to slow the game down a bit because it was getting a bit too crazy. Thought that was a great change, but it also had some radical effects onto the balance, where now mid-fight heroes like Moira, who both have insane mid-fight cooldowns and a fast-charging ultimate, are kind of taking over the support category, and other heroes like them as well, right? When ultimates are weaker, the characters who have a lot of mid-fight cooldowns, like Orisa Sigma, have so many, the other tanks struggle to compete because they actually have less to do in the mid-fight. So that's a problem they haven't really addressed yet, but the one thing that put a slight smile on my face that Jeff responded with is that they aren't afraid to make large gameplay changes like nerfing all the ults in the game, reducing their charge rate. Unfortunately, I just think that it's all going to come a bit slower than we'd all like it to, but it is something on their agenda. Keep in mind that Overwatch 2, Jeff Kaplan said, will probably be talking about it again next BlizzCon, which is to say, it's probably not releasing next year, which is pretty disappointing. We were hoping they were much farther along on this, and the leaks kind of indicated that they were, but perhaps they're going to be iterating on it, and maybe there's going to be a beta next year, but it looks like that development cycle is going to be extended a bit more than we were expecting, and in the meantime, there's going to be work to be done to keep crafting the game that we currently have, and it was nice to hear Jeff say that they're focused on that being the number one priority, because that is the core of what Overwatch is, and Overwatch 2 is an additional thing they also want to do, but obviously, their attention's going to be split, so we're going to have to hold them honest to this moving forward as consumers. Okay, so much going on. What else was important to announce? Well, as you guys know, there is a new PvP game mode coming in Overwatch 2, which, as we've said, sounds like it's going to be quite a while away anyway, but by that point, alongside it, they're going to be adding a handful of PvP maps to all the modes we already have, so that means they're already working on many new maps, and we already thought they had too many maps, and have been asking and begging and pleading for a way to curate the maps, whether it be a map veto, a map vote, or somehow selecting and curating the maps as a player rather than randomly being tossed in to whatever mode the RNG matchmaker puts up for you. Well, there's a little bit of good news coming down the pipeline with this. On that PTR patch next week, they're going to be finally limiting the competitive map pool to a smaller subset of maps, still going to be random, so it's not everything that we would have wanted, but certain annoyance maps that a lot of players don't like are being removed entirely. Paris and Horizon Lunar Colony are going to be the first to get the axe, and I think at this point, not only are some of you jumping out of your chairs, but many more of you are probably begging, well, why not just kill the rest of the assault maps? Let's get all the 2CP maps out of the game. And unfortunately, like a lot of things with Blizzard, we're going to have to settle with a bit of a compromise on this one. I would love to just be able to pick the maps I want to play, or vote in the lobby, or many of the other things that other games have, but it doesn't look like that's going to be the case. Instead, they're going to curate the maps down a bit, which is a step in the right direction, but I'd be lying if I said it's exactly what I wanted. So that's that. We talked about a whole lot of Overwatch 2 and Overwatch 1 crossover problems. I hope that kind of explained it to you in a somewhat concise way. Overwatch 1 is still going to be the focus in the short term. Jeff did talk about role queue, obviously, and said that it was a major success overall and has improved, but they're aware that they have to dig into the next couple problems that the game faces, but it's all just going to take its own time for them to figure out the directions they want to go with that. I wouldn't be surprised if there were also balance changes onto the PTR next week as well, and if not, then shortly thereafter, to continue to curate and change the game. And Jeff specifically said that many players on forums typically want their own individual hero to have the world revolve around them, and they like to spread the love around a little bit and don't want to take a sledgehammer to problems, like for example Double Barrier. They want to carefully let the game evolve over time. That may not be the answer we want to hear, but it is promising that given enough time, they're going to mold the game into something better, hopefully. But without a new hero coming out, it's going to take more significant balance changes, in my opinion, to ramp up the change of the game and make people hyped to play Overwatch 1 right now. I'm hyped to play Overwatch 2. I'm all on board. It might be the better of the two games with the PvE. I am seriously blown away, but deep down, I really want the competitive aspect of Overwatch to come to the forefront. So we'll be discussing this, I'm sure, for quite some time after BlizzCon. So if you want to catch our videos talking about Overwatch 1 and 2, be sure to hit the subscribe button and hit the bell icon so that you actually get notified when our videos go live. Link in the description is our Twitter, where we tweet out news updates and date memes. And don't forget to like the video as well. I've been Frito for your Overwatch. We'll see you guys next time.